portion, we have a wonderful guest speaker that we're going to ask to come on up here with us, Romina.
Romina probably about two years ago. She was transitioning into another position. Said, hey, read this book before you go over there. And when I left the company, I saw Romina on LinkedIn. She looks familiar. And then I realized she had a podcast. And when I got to listen to this, so I started listening to her podcast, and I was just overwhelmed and gobsmacked by what I was hearing Romina do on her podcast and just the quality of the guests that she's had on her podcast. Just an amazing young woman with an entrepreneurial spirit. So I felt like with this inaugural open house, who better to come in than Romina? So
thank you.
I know she's going to say a few things about herself, but I wanted to grill her a little bit because that's what she does on her podcast.
Paul's nice to you, okay?
she doesn't grill anybody. First of all, tell us a little bit about Romina. And
okay.
I'm gonna pull one over on you. Take us from young Romina to now.
Okay, I see what you did there.
See what I did
That's
there?
That's the very first question of every episode, so thank you. So, young Romina to today. I'm Romina. Hi, everybody. Don't even try to say my last name, besides those two right there. Don't ruin it. So, I'm Albanian originally, and I moved to America at 17 by myself. I was lucky enough through a DV visa program through USCIS to get the green card and then the citizenship. So it's a full cycle. And it wasn't easy for me to move here, but I always wanted to improve myself and learn more. So thank goodness my family is very supportive in every crazy stop that I make, and it ended up being good so far. So they fully supported me to move to America. I moved here with the mission of studying pharmacy, going to college, but I didn't like pharmacy, so I just kind of went out there just to kind of explore myself. Probably all of us have been at this stage at some point, trying to find out what you like, what you don't like. So I ended up being in sales, and I talk a lot, so it worked out. And I also love marketing, so kind of merge those two together. And after doing multiple things, always trying to do something new, I kind of hit a plateau and I was kind of bored, so I wanted something different, and I keep listening to podcasts, so I was like, how about I start one? So it started very simple. Like the very first interview, I just keep reaching out to people on LinkedIn. I was so nervous the first interview, I forgot the guy's name. It's horrible. I didn't tell him, but I think he figured that out, and I apologize later. So just kind of put myself out there and just go for it.
So you said something that's pretty interesting. You put yourself out there, and I know I must speak for myself, I don't know about everybody else, but sometimes there's a big fear factor in putting yourself out there. So how did you steel yourself up to put yourself out there, not knowing what was gonna happen?
So if I don't put myself out there, I know what's not going to happen. But I never know who I meet. I mean, I've met wonderful people throughout the journey, like just connecting. We have Ms. Depp right there. I connected with Ms. Depp through one of my school advisors, grabbed coffee, and then just the great communication there. I met through you alone. I got to meet the hostage negotiator, which I had to close him to come to the podcast, so that was fun. And a lot of other wonderful people. So it's like, what do I have to lose if I don't do it?
Right.
I know what I'm not going to achieve.
So first rule of sales, if you don't ask, the answer is always
no.
So what's next on the horizon for for Romina.
Okay. So the podcast is going very good right now, but I kind of, the more through I went through the process, I learned more what I want to do or what I don't want to do. So sometimes you have to take a step back to shoot higher, kind of like, that's why I have a tattoo also. Kind of like, you know, like the heart. So I resigned from my full-time job because I want to fully focus on the podcast, learn more about marketing. Project management is something that I'm very passionate about, so I want to merge those two together. Marketing, project management.